Maybe you've heard that XNAT is the leading open source imaging informatics platform. But what do you get when you start using XNAT? I'm going to guide you through a simple presentation and we'll take a look at what's inside the box. XNAT is a highly extensible web application that runs on an Apache Tomcat server. XNAT can support many kinds of data, but it was engineered for the unique challenges of managing imaging and clinical research data in one system. Notably, it allows you to store indexed research data and image files in the same system. XNAT comes with additional utilities for processing data, such as the pipeline engine and the Docker server for container service. It also offers support for scripted automations. Here's how it's organized. XNAT has a project-oriented data and permissions model. This means that project owners have complete control over who has access to their data and what they can do with it. With XNAT, you can store indexed, searchable experiment data in a Postgres database, as well as resource files in a file system. XNAT has an extensible XML-based data model, which means that you can support nearly any kind of tabular data with a defined XNAT data type. At the core of XNAT is its API, which is used for requesting and displaying data, as well as uploading, downloading, and removing data from your system. The API is tied to the user permission model, providing the same level of access to users as through the front end. So how do you get data into it? XNAT has built-in methods for uploading image session data, or acting as an SCP receiver on your network so that other DICOM devices, such as a PACS system, can send data to it. XNAT also has built-in methods for importing large quantities of experiment data, as well as a customizable UI for manual data entry. To guard against inadvertent PHI entry, you can proof imported image data in a pre-archive before you finalize storage in the archived file system. You can also set up an automated anonymization method in XNAT to prevent any PHI from being inadvertently imported into your research system and DICOM data. Security and access control. Permissions in XNAT are granted to users on a project-by-project basis. This means that project owners have discrete control over who has access to their data and what they can do with it. All project owners can search and filter on stored data according to any number of criteria, and can share data into new projects and download data as well. A smaller number of project users can add, edit, or delete data, or invite fellow users to collaborate. Site administrators like you have access to robust user administration tools across all projects on your site. XNAT uses Spring Security by default for local authentication and access control. But with additional plugins, you could use an LDAP server or OpenID for authentication. Advanced users can also use XNAT's API to generate an alias token. This creates a valid login session for your external applications. Let's talk about extensibility. XNAT's plugin architecture means that you can easily add features and functionality. Other plugins that can be installed include support for LDAP authentication, a PACS query tool, and powerful new image viewer that lets you draw and save ROIs and annotations. XNAT natively supports processing pipelines through its pipeline engine, and can also support containerized processing using the container service plugin. And this is really just the start of what you can find and do within this platform. Let's keep going to learn more.